Three competing brands of cereal are being sold in the school cafeteria. Brand Z's weekly sales are affected by the sales of the other two products. For each $1 increase in Brand X's sales, there is an increase of 40 cents in sales of Brand Z. Similarly, each $1 increase in Brand Y's sales, there is a decrease of 30 cents in sales of Brand Z. If the current sales of Brand X, Y, and Z are $24, $77, and $59 respectively, write an equation for Z's sales in terms of X and Y. So the first thing to recognize here is that we will have a linear equation where Z is defined in terms of X and Y. We know the equation is going to be linear because for each $1 increase in Brand X's sales, Z's sales increases by the constant amount of 40 cents. And for every $1 increase in Brand Y's sales, there's a constant decrease of 30 cents in the sales of Brand Z. Looking at our notes below, a linear multivariable function of two variables must be in the form of f of x, comma y or z equals m sub x times x plus m sub y times y plus b, where m sub x is the slope in the x direction, which is the ratio of the change of z to the change in x, and m sub y is the slope in the y direction, which gives the ratio of the change of z to the change in y. And because our brands are x, y, and z, and we're defining z in terms of x and y, we'll be using the same variables, which means our equation is going to be in the form of z equals m sub x times x plus m sub y times y plus b. And now we begin by determining the slope in the x direction and the slope in the y direction. Going back to the given information, for each $1 increase in Brand X's sales, there's an increase of 40 cents in sales of Brand Z. So the ratio of the change of Z to the change in X is 40 cents to $1, which simplifies to 0.4. And then for the slope in the Y direction, each $1 increase in Brand Y's sales, there is a decrease of 30 cents in sales of Brand Z. So the ratio of the change of Z to the change in Y is negative 30 cents, negative because it's decreasing by 30 cents to $1, which simplifies to negative 0.3. So now for our equation, we know that Z must equal M sub X times X is 0.4X, and then plus M sub Y times Y is plus negative 0.3 times Y, or just minus 0.3Y. plus b. And now we still need to find the constant b. We can do this because we know the current sales of x, y, and z are $24, $77, and $59 respectively. So to find b, we substitute 24 for x, 77 for y, and 59 for z. Performing the substitution gives us 59 is equal to 0.4 times 24. Minus 0.3 times 77 plus b. And now we solve the equation for b. 59 equals 0.4 times 24 is equal to 9.6. Minus 0.3 times 77 is 23.1. Combining like terms, 9.6 minus 23.1 is negative 13.5. Solving for b, we add 13.5 to both sides. Simplifying, we have b equals 59 plus 13.5 is 72.5. And now we have everything we need to write our linear equation that relates z to x and y. We now know z is equal to 0.4x minus 0.3y plus 72.5. This is the equation that relates Z sales in terms of X and Y. I hope you found this helpful.